Bonjour!
Bonjour!
No.
Time for bladder check.
Check.
So, it's a show?
It's a lifestyle. It's a religion.
My emotions! My emotions!
I'm still French.
Ouais, c'est pas faux.
I'm a woman, Mary. I can be as contrary as I choose.
Non, moi je crois qu'il faut que vous arrêtiez d'essayer de dire des trucs.
Hello! Hi! I'm Laura. I'm gonna watch Attack on Titan Season 1, Episode 18. This morning I watched the episode 17. If you want to see my reaction video about that, I'm gonna put the link into the eye. That was a great episode, and normally this afternoon I'm gonna watch 3 episodes. I love so much to binge watch shows like that. Like, I don't have to wait each week to have a new episode. It's so cool. I read your comments. You were telling me that you have to rush so you can be right on time for the next season and all. Like, guys, 4 seasons to catch up. I mean, it's easy when you are watching them on your own, but when you're making reaction videos about it, it means that I would have to film all of my reactions to all of the 4 seasons, that I would have, what, 5 or 6, you know, things, drive things, just to have the files somewhere, like, no. And also that you guys, you would have at least 1 episode each hour. I can't do that. I'm sorry, I'm not a machine, you know, and I want to take my time also to watch it, to enjoy it really. And right now on my channel, I'm already reacting to Attack on Titan, to Death Note, to The Legend of Korra, to Arcane, to The Wheel of Time, soon to The X-Men, to La Casa de Papel, to The Witcher. I'm not a machine. Guys, really, I'm doing my best, I swear, but no, I'm not gonna be right on time for the last season. When it's gonna be out, I'm gonna avoid Twitter during that time. Like, at least during 1 week, I'm gonna try my best to avoid Twitter, to avoid spoilers. But I can't be right on time for the last season. Okay, about what happened during the last episode. A female titan. A female clever titan. So we have a woman who can create Titan around her like Eren is doing, but also like maybe someone else is doing for the Colossal Titan and for the Armored Titan. So that lady, that woman, her mission right there, it was maybe to lead all of these Titans to meet, you know, all of these soldiers, you know, all of the Recon Corps, to be sure that this mission is not gonna be accomplished. Maybe it was more to target Eren. I think that we're gonna discover that during this episode. But no matter what, she was running and she stopped her run to check Armin's face. He thought that it was because of the fact that he was not Eren that she didn't kill him. But after that, she tried to kill Reyna. And before that, she also already killed someone else. Like, I don't think that it was because of the fact that you were not Eren that she didn't kill you. I think that it was because of the fact that you are Armin. And that's why when he began to talk and all, she stopped because she was listening to what he was saying. I think that this clever female titan, it's someone who knows Armin, who wants to protect Armin. And I would think that maybe it can be your mother. I mean, we know that your parents died, but I can't remember how they died. Did we have a clue about that, an information about that at some point? I can't remember. For me, she has to be someone who cares about you, who knows you, so maybe your mother. But about her? The fact that she knows about that mission, the fact that she knows that Eren can do that, can transform himself into a titan, it means that she has the information, that woman inside of that titan. So it means that she learned it by herself when she was inside of the world, or someone told her, you know, by sending her a message. Someone from the inside. And we know that some of these people, they are inside because they killed the titans that Zoe was studied. And you know my theory, when I'm saying they, you know that my theory about this they, it's people, a group of persons. Dr. Yeager was a part of that group. They created the primitive titans, maybe based on actual humans, dead or alive. That's why, you know, old one, young one, female, male. And they tried to improve their experiences. That's why we have different levels of titans. That's why we have some abnormal ones. And they ended by creating these clever titans that maybe they can summon. Maybe it's them, you know, people of this group inside of these clever titans. Maybe it's other people. Why they are doing all of that? I really don't know. My only theory in which I believe, like at 3%, it's maybe it's a political and demographic almost situation. Like they wanted to be sure that no one would go outside of this world, so that's why they created enemies so no one would go out. But inside there were too many, like too many people to feed, like the balance between how many people you have and the resources that you have to feed them, that was not good anymore. So that's why clever titans destroyed the world so you can eat and kill people inside. Really 3%. To believe into that theory, 3%. But my theory that people created the primitive titans and the clever titans, 80%. Really, I'm at 80% sure of that theory. I'm talking like L in Death Note in percentages. So that woman inside of that female titan, she knows stuff because she was inside or because someone told her. But no matter what, she knows Armin. And if she was inside, it means that she crossed the wall, you know? Like, how can she pass the wall, that woman, right there? Like, the recon corps, like, you have to open the gate and all of that. So, she did it with the recon corps or at the same time. With these writers and how they are playing with stuff, like during the last episode when they played with Rainer being dead, not dead, dead, not dead. I am beginning to think that maybe with these writers I have to expect a reveal at some point. One of the reveals, because I think that we're gonna have plenty of reveals, maybe one of the reveals is gonna be one of the person, you know, of this group. It's someone that we already know, or maybe that someone that we already know is one of the clever titans. And or. It's already hard to have theories about these titans, how and why they are created, to have theories about what is happening right there in the action, the present time for the characters. And now I'm trying to make theories about what the writers are gonna maybe do later with the reveals and with things like that. Okay, so we're gonna continue that mission. So I think that right there during this episode we're gonna have news about Eren, how he's gonna deal with that female titan. That female titan was protecting that part of her, so really a clever one. She knows that they can touch her right there, and now she's gonna know that they know. That's what I mean. I'm beginning to go crazy with all of this series. It's episode 18 of the season 1. Maybe not during this episode, but maybe during one of the two other episodes that I'm gonna try to watch today, we can have a reveal about who is that female titan. You know, it could be great before the end of the season to have some reveals, some big informations to totally disturb the viewers and me right now. Like you already watched all of the show, but for me right now, before the end of the season, it could be great. Like, we're not gonna go and discover the secret basement during this season at the rhythm that we are progressing into this territory. It's gonna take us all of the season 2 to go to the secret basement. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking right now. Let's go for this episode. If you want, like usually, you have my Patreon on which you can have the episodes earlier. We have 2 episodes of advance for Attack on Titan. And we've extended our 4 reaction parts. It's the best way to support me. Right there on YouTube, you can like, subscribe, comment. It's helping me. Not with the tips, you know, the little tips that I could have for these videos, because it's really hard for animes, and in particular for Attack on Titan, even more than for Death Note. It's painful, almost. It's really the word for that. It's painful. You can thank really all of your reactors, like if you're watching really a lot of videos about Attack on Titan, please thank all of your reactors because they're fighting hard for these videos. Let's go for this episode! Who is gonna die? Who is gonna nearly die during this episode? What they did with Reiner during the last one, they had me! I had tears for no reason. I mean, for some reasons, but he didn't die. I'm glad that he didn't die, but oh, you got what I meant. I'm gonna be mad at you now. Forest of giant trees. Okay. Yeah. You're not afraid of people being hearing you. No one? You're not gonna make that decision. Jan, really? I put a lot of hope on you. Can we talk about that? She was looking at you directly. No! Cool! Yes? The sweet girl! Yes! She's sweet! Oh, maybe too sweet. No! Oh. Oh! You're all falling in love with her. You can! She's sweet! So the female is gonna come just after them, normally. You? See, she's just running and protecting her like she doesn't care. Her purpose is not to kill you, but if she has to, she's gonna do it. I mean, the spin, yes, the tendons, I'm not sure, because of the fact that she can repair herself, you know, fix herself, like Eren. If she can run, she can jump. Come on! She didn't kill Armin because it was Armin. But all of the other guys, she doesn't care. Your mother, someone who loves you, who cares about you. Oh no! Oh boy! I'm sorry! It's not just not normal. Can't you see it? Are you tired? No. She switched direction, you know, because she saw the green flares, or she felt, you know, that everyone changed also the direction. It's not good at all. They can hide with these giant trees. You can also hide from them. Hide. I trust Erwin. I'm not sure I'm right, but he knows stuff. Are you sure that they are not already inside? I don't understand either. You don't want to just move anymore? You want to stay there? No. What is happening into that forest? You want to have time into it? Something like that? Obey. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't mean that he can't sing by himself. Okay, stupid one. You can take it away. Mm-hmm. It's stupid. I have the impression that you're insulting me also, Levi, when you're talking like that. With all of these trees, you can use them and maybe kill most of the titans, but not the female one. To make a trap for them. Oh! In a way, yes, you don't have to fight. You're baiting them. It's only for the female. I'm not targeting Eren, these titans. That thing! You know what we're talking about, Levi. Eren, but do you want to kill him or to catch him? I don't know why I just said that. Should I? You want to fight? What are you waiting, Levi? Thank you. What is it? These writers. Bad writers. Really bad writers. Sneaky writers. They really know how to make cliffhangers. For sure. But you know, all of that final scene with the action, with everyone waiting for Levi to say something, to do something, to tell them to fight, the music was going like that, you know, we were waiting for the climax of the music being like, it's gonna happen, something is gonna happen. And at the end, he's not saying, we're gonna fight, let's go. No, he's saying, cover your ears, like, you're surprised, you want to know why. He's taking the gun, he press on it. Boom! End of the episode. writers, writer, you tell me that it's only one person with that the origin, you know, of the anime, I think the anime, but for the adaptation on screen, maybe there are more, you know, I don't know. But I'm used to say writers, so I'm sorry if in the future I'm saying writers, saying that. Fuck you. Really, the tension, the pressure. Levi is gonna say something. Levi is gonna tell us to fight. No, he's not telling us. Ching, poom. It was so anti. I don't know how to say it in English. The comparison is gonna be weird, but follow me with it. It's really like when you are excited and it's not happening. You know what moment I'm talking about. If you are adults watching me right now, watching my videos, we know, okay? That moment. Fuck you. I didn't see it coming, you know, the plan into the forest with the giant trees. I didn't think about it. You know, when I saw them going into that forest, I was like, that's really bad, like, all of these titans, you're not gonna be able to see them coming, so they're gonna surprise you, it's really dangerous for you. And I didn't think, you know, about the contrary, I didn't turn the thing on the other side, you know, the fact that, yes, they're not gonna be able to see you also, and in fact, when you are on the countryside with no trees, it's dangerous for you. They said it during the previous episode. And in a forest, it's way better for you to kill titans. And this particular one, even more. Okay. Okay, that was a fucking good plan, Erwin. And you wanted everyone to stop the other titans at the beginning of the forest. They don't have to do anything for that because titans are just titans, so they want to eat and kill humans. They are seeing you like that on the trees, so they are really like little kittens trying to reach you. I think that they're gonna be forced to fight at some point, you know, because so many titans doing that on a tree, the tree is gonna fall, no? No matter what, they're gonna be forced to fight, I think. Just to escape from that tree, they're gonna be forced to fight. They're not gonna stay right there forever. That female titan is targeting Eren, that's for sure. Was leading all of the titans on that direction, but she's the one with the purpose, not all of them. So that's why right there, they saw humans, they want to kill these humans. They don't care, you know, about Eren and all. She targets Eren. Why did I say during the episode, do you want to kill him or do you want to catch him? It was a feeling, you know. Maybe because of the fact that I have this theory now that this female titan knows Armin. Because of the fact that she didn't kill Armin, she listened to his voice and all of that, like she cares about him. For that, my theory is murder, you know. We don't know how they died, like they said that they died, but... You know my rule, I need to see that body count ice class. If I didn't see that, now I can suppose that they are not dead. And maybe it's your mother. But if she knows Armin, she knows Eren also, so maybe she's not gonna want to kill him because of that, just to catch him, just to stop him, block him. Maybe she's not gonna kill him because of the fact that I think that she knows that he can transform himself into a titan, you know, to target him like that, she has to know, which means also that she learned it into the walls, or someone inside of the walls told her, like, sent a message and something like that, which is really bad. Again, an organization, a group of people, maybe spies, like persons that we know who are into that group. I'm beginning to imagine stuff like that now. But that woman, if I'm right about who she knows Eren, and she knows also what Eren is, can do. So maybe she's not gonna want to kill him because of that. But she doesn't care about killing other soldiers, like during that fight, clearly she was killing these soldiers. but not Armin. What do we know about her? I mean, what did we learn more during this episode? She runs, she's fast, she can jump, she's protecting her spin no matter what. It's really like, she's so aware. Maybe it's that, you know, which is so shocking me. She's so aware of who she is, you know, like what her weakness is. It's making me think that you had the time to train to be that titan, you know. Like all of these clever titans, the colossal ones, the armored titan, the female titan, they're also aware of their strengths, of what they have to do, how to do it, you know, like her, to take the time to be like that with Armin and all, it means that you trained to be a titan. We saw Eren and how difficult it was for him to have conscious of himself, to take the control of the titan that he created, to do stuff, you know, all of the energy that it demands him, and to create it, but also to make it have a purpose. So for a clever titan, that female titan, to do things like that, to run for so long, to fight like that, to be so quick and all, to take that time to do that thing, that scene with Armin. You trained, you... For how many years you trained? I had that theory editing the other episode. You know, when I was thinking about the secret basement, a lot of time during the intro and reviews, I said stuff like, come on, that secret basement is waiting for you since entire years. If you want to find information into it, really, it's gonna turn into dust. Like, you're not gonna find anything. Everything is gonna be erased by years, by water, by, you know, wind and stuff like that. You're not gonna find anything because you're too late, in fact. And that's gonna be really all of that for nothing. That's what I said during the intro and review. But editing these intros and reviews, I thought more about it, and I thought that maybe it's not information that we're gonna find into this basement, you know? It's gonna be things which can't be destroyed by years. All of these 5 years, I can't remember how many that passed, it needs to be something which cannot be destroyed. With what I'm saying right now about the fact that maybe people inside can send a message to people outside, can we think that maybe during that period of time into your secret basement, Dr. Jaeger, we had a passage, a tunnel, you know, to go out of the walls? Can it be possible that in fact it's a passage, a tunnel, something which cannot be destroyed, something which can tell you an information? For me it would work. Okay, it could be better to have informations like Dr. Jaeger, who wrote a little diary each day saying all of his plan, all of this group plan, all of what they want to do. I would love that. But I'm not sure on that, you know? I don't know. I had this thought during the editing and thinking about that female titan and these informations which are traveling behind walls. Okay, I'm gonna stop this review because I want to watch 2 more episodes today, and if I want to finish with actual light and not my horrifying yellow light, I have to hurry a little. So it's all for you for today, and it's all for me for now, so bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me you built a time machine? Right.